Hi, everybody. Welcome to Squirrel Pie Productions, my podcast about knitting, spinning, and sewing. My name is Tommy. You can find me on Ravelry as Dynamite Trujillo and on Instagram now as Squirrel Pie Productions. We have a Ravelry group that you are welcome to join. That's where you'll find the show notes for today's episode and last week's episode. So come on over, feel free to join the group and join in the conversation if you'd like. Today's Friday. It's kind of early afternoon Friday, getting close to Christmas here in December. I am spending the morning at home with Squirrel Pie, which you might be able to see a little bit of right there, and my new Christmas tree, which is over there off camera, and my new Santa mug. Both of which I got last weekend. Last weekend I went to a local Christmas tree farm and cut down my own Charlie Brown tree. That was really fun. It was a really cool place that gave me hot cider and cookies and a saw and let me out in their field. And I got a nice little 4 or 5 foot tree. It's great. I love it. I also went to the thrift store last weekend and bought myself this pretty amazing Santa mug, which I'm excited about. I've got some tea in him today to try to warm myself up because it is cold in my house right now. So yeah, it's still too hot to drink, but this is a pretty cheap, thin mug, so it's really doing a good job warming my hands up right now. But today I will be talking with you about my knitting and my sewing. So I've got a couple new knitting projects on the needles this week that I'll show you, and a couple continuing from last time. First, I think I'll show you my Carpino pullover. I'm a little bit farther along, not much. I've got the hip increases almost finished. I think last week I had the hip increases just about started. So here she is so far. This is the Carpino pullover, a Brooklyn tweed pattern by Carol Feller. It is a pullover with a stockinette back, lace front. It's a top-down raglan style. I'm knitting it out of Brooklyn tweed loft, which is what is used in the pattern. This is the tartan colorway. And yeah, I'm way down here. So I'm almost done with the body. I'll be starting on the ribbing soon, and then I'll do the sleeves. I think there probably is a little bit of a neck band, so I'll pick up and do that too. This is so nice to work with. I love working with Brooklyn tweed yarn. It's nice and airy and light and warm and natural feeling. It feels like wool. I love it. So this is the cake I am working with right now, and I've got one skein left that I'm sure I'll break into when I start the sleeves. And yeah, I've got again my sprinkle donut progress keeper marking the beginning of the round. I love this pullover. I can't wait till it's done. I can't wait to wear it. It's gonna be so nice and warm. I have a thing for these lace front, stockinette back pullovers. This is the third one I've made. I just keep doing it. I love them. This is living in my Fat Squirrel Fibers Birdie bag. And I am using size 4 signature needles. Yay! My next work in progress is another one continuing from last week. You can see the silhouette of my Christmas tree on the wall back here. That's my Christmas tree. I've got a big front window in my living room right here, and the Christmas tree is right in front of it, so that's neat. My next work in progress is living in a project bag that I made out of some Ghastly's fabric, and I love it. I love the Ghastly's. It's such a cool print. My favorite Ghastly is her. I have big dreams someday of being her for Halloween. Look at that dress. I'm going to make that dress. I actually have shoes very similar to that. And I'm totally going to be here for Halloween one year. I also have my pink pom-pom on this. And I lined this bag with this really cool jewel sort of spiderweb fabric. And living in this bag is my Anissa shawl. This is what she looks like so far. I'm using my hand spun and some Madeline Tosh Tosh Merino Light. The hand spun is from the bottom all the way up to right about here where I started the striping. And that's the Madeline Tosh Tosh Merino Light in the gossamer colorway. And these are them. This is my hand spun. It is Southern Cross Fibers in the Paris colorway, Polworth and Tessa Silk, if I remember correctly. Tosh Merino Light in the gossamer colorway. And I think they go really nicely together. I think they're gonna make a really nice Anissa shawl. The Anissa shawl is my very favorite shawl I've ever made, which I showed you last time. And I'm really excited to be making a second one. I get a lot of wear out of my first one. So I'm not too far into it. It's a really, really big shawl, so it's probably gonna take me quite a while to finish. My favorite thing about this shawl, other than it's a rectangular shawl, which I love, is this detail here, which is a center double decrease, I think it's called. And this runs from the bottom, from one corner at the bottom to the other corner at the top, right diagonally through the shawl. And I'm really enjoying it so far. I love working with hand spun. And this is some really nice, squishy, soft hand spun. A lot of garter stitch, which I think is really fun. And that's what's happening in my gas sleeves bag this week. Next up, I have got some new socks. This is going to be my 13th pair of socks for the year. Not going in my box of socks, Cal, though, because it is a gift knit. This is the first pair of socks that I will ever be making for someone else, which is a little scary, but it's fun. I've got one cuff done so far. This is Fiber Nymph Dyeworks in the Longest Night colorway. It's a self-striping with different shades of blue, gray, and white. This is what it looks like in a really messy cake. This is yarn that I've had for a while. It was a club colorway from December 2014. And last summer, I had started knitting this into a pair of socks for myself. And my mom came to visit, saw me knitting them, decided that she really liked them, and she wanted a pair too out of the same yarn. So I actually decided to just rip them out and cast them on again for her. She tried on the socks I was making for myself, which was a 56 stitch sock. It was too small for her. So I'm trying 64 stitches with this one. I hope they fit. We'll see. She's actually going to be visiting again for Christmas. She'll be here this next week. And I won't be done with these by the time she gets here, so I'll try them on her and see how they're fitting so far. I think they're going to fit fine. So we'll see. I probably won't be finished with these by the time she leaves, so I might have to mail them to her when they're done. But like I said, Fiber Nymph Dyeworks, it's in her Bounce Base, which is an 80-20 Super Wash Merino Nylon. Longest Night colorway. And I think it's a Christmas colorway. So that's cool. These are on my Hiya Sharps US size 1 Magic Loop, my favorite method of knitting socks. The cuff was done on a size 0. My size zeros are carbons. And I actually bought a second pair of these size one Hi-Hi Sharps because I only had one before. I usually only knit one pair of socks at a time. And I really wanted to try knitting two socks consecutively on two separate needles. So I bought a second pair, and I was going to do that method with these socks, but this yarn was already caked up, and it's caked up so messy that I, for one, didn't think I could pull from the outside and the inside, because it had been knit and then ripped out and then kind of wound around itself, and I didn't want to rewind it into a second ball. But I might try that with some future pairs of socks. I'm actually a little apprehensive of trying it now that I think about it, because I kind of don't want to wind my ball of yarn into two separate balls, because I usually have a lot of yarn left over after knitting socks, and I don't want to have two separate balls as leftovers. So I don't know, we'll see. I might try pulling from the outside and the inside of the cake instead. That seems like it might get tangly though. So I don't know. I did get a new pair of Hi-Hi Sharps though. And now that I'm looking at them, it's funny. I don't really know what the difference is, but they're a little bit different. These Hi-Hi Sharps have a green cable, which I don't know if you'll be able to see. These ones, which you can tell, have a blue cable. So I wonder if they're different. I don't know. But, ooh, cool. I just noticed that these came with a pink locking stitch marker. I really like these kinds of stitch markers, and I really like these pink ones. I forgot that another pink one came with my other Hi-Hi Sharps, and I forgot they send you these. I love these. So cool. Yay, socks! 13th pair for the year. I'm pretty proud of myself. That's pretty cool. I probably won't get these done by the end of the year, but we'll see. I might. And these are living in another project bag that I made for myself. This is cats with antlers with a pink zipper. And I've just got canvas lining in here. But I love this fabric. I think this is freaking adorable. My last work in progress is a big, giant, scrappy shawl. This is living in my Gustler Designs tote bag with Yarn Chicken on it. This chicken's nervous because he's playing Yarn Chicken. I like him. So in here we have got the Outline Shawl by Beata Jezik. Hope I'm pronouncing that right. She's the dyer behind Hedgehog Fibers. And she wrote this really awesome pattern for a giant rectangular shawl in this kind of broken chevron sort of pattern. It's a really easy pattern to memorize. It's a two-row repeat. Super easy. I'm hoping it just kind of goes on forever and it turns out really, really big and wide and giant. And what I'm doing with this is I'm using all of my sport weight scraps and I'm just gonna use them all up, stripe them one after another until they're all gone. So yeah, I'm excited about this. I've got these on my size 7 Knit Picks wooden interchangeable needles. And this first yarn I've got on here is some MCN. This is actually a fingering weight, but it's a sport weight. This was a sport weight yarn. I used it in a fingering weight project though, because it's kind of a thin sport weight. It's really nice, really pretty, kind of dusty rose color. I forget what yarn it was. but I had knit one of Molly from a homespun house's patterns. I think it was the windswept shawl, possibly. And I actually gave that to my mom. She, this seems to happen a lot. She came over to visit, saw me wearing it, liked it, so I gave it to her. But I had a lot of yarn left over, so I think I may have bought two skeins and only used one and a little bit of the second one. So this is the first one. I've got a bunch of other stuff in here that looks like that. Which I guess you can't see that well. So I'll take some of them out. This is Blackwater Abbey Yarns. I used this to make a pair of mittens last year. It's this really pretty kind of purplish, grayish, mauvish sort of color. There we go. And then I've got some Quince & Co. in their sport weight. I think that's the chickadee. I knit a sweater out of that. Got some hand spun. I forget what this is. Some baby llama. This is some kind of silk blend. I think it's got like, what's the rabbit fur called? No, no, it's not rabbit fur. Silk, mohair, wool, and cotton. I don't know. I've had this for a long time. I've never made anything out of it because I honestly kind of don't like it that much. So I figured it'd be a good addition to a scrappy shawl. I have some leftover Knit Circus, I think it is. This was a gradient. And this is some weird hand-dyed yarn that I dyed myself that I'll talk a little bit more about later. And a bunch of weird stuff in here. So that's all going to be striped up into this lovely, giant, massive stole shawl thing. I'm really excited about this. So that'll probably be on the needles for a while too. So that is everything I've been knitting on this week. I have one FO. It's my pair of socks that I was working on last week. And excitingly, it is living in my box of socks, which is this kind of crazy cinnamon roll box with all my 12 pairs smashed into it. They totally don't really fit, but I got them all smashed in here. So that's my box of socks. That is my FO from last week. And it is Madeline Tosh in the Euro sock, which is their 100% superwash merino base. And this is what it looks like. Yay! I really like these socks a lot. A whole lot. Love this yarn a lot. I love the colorway. I did kind of my standard 56 stitch top down 2x2 cuff, heel flap, and gusset. Modified rounded toe with the Kitchener at the end, and they fit really well, and this yarn is just really nice and woolly and bouncy and spongy. These are really great socks. I love them. Here's the other one. This one's a little more speckled than the second pair or the second sock. But it's just got such pretty colors in here. We've got hot pinks and purples and oranges and blues and stuff. There you go. Pretty. Light Brights colorway. is what it is. It was in Madeline Tosh's holiday collection this year. So these were kind of my Christmas socks. Fun. And I think I'll go through and show you all of my other 11 pairs from my box. The box of socks, by the way, was a year-long, 2016 and along, with Kristen of the Yarngasm podcast. And it was really inspiring. Knitting all these socks this year has been so much fun. The pair that I did right before this, I showed you last week. This was my Demon Unicorn socks, Once Upon a Corgi Yarns. Before that, I had my, what are these ones? Unicorns in the 80s socks. This was, hold on, I've got it written down. Greenwood Fiber Works yarn. I got this yarn at the Black Sheep Fiber Fair in Oregon earlier this year. That's got Stellina in it, as did the other unicorn socks. Before that, I had my Autumn and Mint socks, which is a coloring book yarns colorway. I really, really liked working on these. This is one of those sock weight bases that's a little beefier than some others. So they're really thick and really squishy, and I really, really like them. Same construction here too. All of them so far have been the same. Coloring Book Yarns is so amazing. I love her stuff. Before that, we have kind of my favorite pair of socks I've ever made. This is Jill Draper Makes Stuff Esopus in the Under the Cover of Darkness colorway. Same construction. This was before I started kitcheneering the toe. This is the pattern for the rounded toe as written in the Sock Architecture book by Laura Neal. And the way she has you do it is you start decreases way up here and kind of do multiple decreases, kind of like a hat decrease, way down until you only have a few stitches on the needle. You tie it through. So that's how I used to do it. But I just love this yarn so much. It's 100% superwash merino. Really stretchy, really squishy. It's super high twist, so when you held the yarn, it had a lot of give, a lot of stretch to it. And these socks are just super comfortable. They're super snug and thick, and they fit really well. I love these socks. They're my favorites. These are some Opal. I think the collection or the colorway was a love story, and I got this yarn at Stitches West 2015, I think. And then I've got that hand-dyed cake I showed you earlier that I said I'd talk about later. This is the socks that I made out of that yarn. And I dyed this in a hand painting workshop that I went to at my LYS a couple years ago. And the colorway's okay. I like it fine. But I don't like the yarn itself that much. It's a BFL base. And kind of how the workshop went was they had a bunch of acid dyes out, and they had you hand painting it like on a table with saran wrap and paintbrushes. And then when you were done, you'd give it to him and he would microwave it for you. And I don't, honestly, that kind of turned me off. I don't really like microwaves that much. And I think I would have rather tried immersion dyeing, but I wasn't really aware of what technique I was going to be using when I signed up for the workshop. But I kind of honestly didn't like the hand paint then microwave method. I don't think I'll do that ever again. Plus, when I washed these, they bled like a lot. And I made a super rookie mistake by soaking them with one of my favorite shawls, and it totally bled into my shawl. And I kind of ruined it, but I still wear it. But I kind of hold a grudge against these socks for that. Totally my own stupid fault, but still, I kind of hate them. But I still wear them. I've got a Fish Lips Kiss Heel on these ones. And Fish Lips Kiss Heel is super fun to work on. I like making it. It doesn't fit me the best, though, not nearly as well as the heel flap and gusset. So that's these, my hand-dyed socks. My next pair, maybe my least favorite pair, maybe next to those ones, but these are some Cascade socks. I'm honestly not super into Cascade yarn, but I had it, and I knit some blueberry waffle socks out of it. The blueberry waffle pattern is really great. It fits super nicely, but it wasn't that fun to knit. Kind of for me, anything that isn't a vanilla sock is less fun than a vanilla sock. So these were kind of a slog. They took me a long time. The pattern wasn't that fun, and the yarn wasn't that great. I just wasn't that into it. But they fit really well. They're nice. Nice socks. Next is some Lollipop Yarns socks. This is the Best Friends colorway. And her yarn is always really amazing. So, love that. This one's got a regular wedge toe. I think this may have been one of the last pairs of socks that I made a wedge toe for. I used to always do a wedge toe before I switched to the rounded toe. And I realized I don't like how it fits. But I still really like these socks. Lollipop Yarns does such beautiful work. I love her stuff. Next, I have got some Rye socks. This is a Tin Can Knits pattern. It's garter on the front, stockinette on the back. These are worsted weight socks. So I used Malabrigo Rios for these. And they're super squishy, super comfortable, super long. It's another thing. I really like a long sock. So I make all my socks pretty long. So that's them. This is Mustache Yarns in the Retro Rainbow colorway. Really cool, fun, muted rainbow self-striping. This is another one where, oh, you know what? I think this is a sport weight sock. I was gonna say this was a thicker sock yarn, but I'm pretty sure this is sport weight. I really like sport weight socks. I like a thicker, warmer sock. So these were awesome. And my last pair are these socks. Yarn is from Julie Spins in the peach colorway. Kind of this peachy, yellowy background with these pink speckles in it. So I think that's 12, right? I actually think I'm missing a pair, another Lollipop Yarns, which I knit back in January. So I think I might have 13, but I don't know, maybe I'll show you those later. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, yay! So, box of socks, it was super fun. There's going to be another box of socks cal for 2017. Super excited about that. I'm definitely going to do it again. Maybe I'll get a bigger box next time that'll actually fit all my socks in it without having to smash them down too hard. And that is all my knitting for the week. It's been a fun knitting week. A lot of after work sitting by the fire working on my sweater kind of knitting. I've got a little bit of sewing to show you. I actually have been hiding my sewing project from you because it is, like I said, cold in my house, and I'm wearing it, but it's under a bunch of layers. This, by the way, is my Leoc cowl that I've had for a while. It's out of some Swan's Island worsted. Super warm, super squishy. It's a nice long cowl. And I wear this whenever I want to keep really, really warm, which is right now. But I am going to show you my Agnes top. I made this last weekend out of that Under the Sea fabric. And here she is. This is my kind of favorite top knit fabric top pattern. It's by Tilly and the Buttons. It's got this nice scoop neck, these, what would this be? Quarter sleeves, I guess. And it's a nice length. I really like it. And I've got these octopi and dolphins and turtles and fishies on it. So this was a success. I love this pattern. This is the second one I've made. I plan to make a lot more. I'm putting my sweater back on now because it's cold. I am finding out about myself that I really, really love sewing with knits, making jersey clothing. I've made quite a few patterns with jersey. I've made quite a few sewing patterns with non-jersey fabrics, quilting cottons and cotton poplins and a couple of other things. And really, I found that the only ones I ever wear consistently are the knit ones. And I think that's because they fit better. They're so much more forgiving, and I can sew something in a jersey cotton and it's just so far always fit. Whereas the things I've knit out of a non-stretchy fabric so far have never fit perfectly. So I kind of never wear them. So I really like sewing with that kind of fabric. My next project I have coming up is another knit fabric project. It is going to be out of this, which is some fabric I've had for about a year now. And I think I'm gonna make the ultimate wrap dress pattern. That is a sewing pattern by Sew Over It. And I'm excited about that. I purchased the downloadable pattern last weekend. I still have to print it out, tape it together, and get it going. I really prefer working with an already printed pattern because I kind of hate taping together pattern pieces, and I feel like I'm not that good at it, so they always come out a little off. But I didn't want to wait for it to come in the mail, so I've got that going. Hopefully I'll make it this weekend out of this cool kind of Scandinavian print jersey fabric. I've got another sewing project that I want to figure out what to do with. Pretty much, I have this Gastly's Christmas fabric that is just so amazingly awesome. I really want to do something with it. I don't know what to do with it, though. I have, I think, a half a yard, maybe, and it's so awesome, and I want to make something with it before Christmas. I don't know what to make yet, though. I kind of thought about making maybe a stocking, but I'm having my family over to my house for Christmas, so if I made myself a stocking, there would only be one stocking, and it would be for me, and that doesn't seem fair. So I don't think I'll do that. I thought about making a Christmas tree skirt, but I didn't, and now I've got another piece of fabric under my Christmas tree. I don't know if I have enough to make like a skirt or something. I also don't know if I would wear a skirt like this out of quilting cotton. I'm not sure. So I'm gonna figure it out. See what I also thought about just framing it, just taking a big panel of this, putting it in a frame and putting it up on my wall for Christmas. So I don't know. We'll see. If you have any ideas, let me know. So I'd love to do something with this for this Christmas and put it somewhere in my house. 'Cause it's super cool. That's it for sewing. I have a little bit of stash enhancement, kind of. It's a bag. The Fat Squirrel put out this really awesome bag with these goats on it, and these skulls, and these flowers and birds. And I love it. It's so cool. Cool teal zipper. I love goats. I'm a big goat fan. Natural lining. So I just got this in the mail yesterday, I think. I can't wait to put something in it and start using it. Like I said before, Fat Squirrel makes kind of my favorite project bags. I just love them. And that's all I bought this week, luckily. For my kind of favorite section, I wanted to talk a little bit about what I've been fantasizing about knitting. There are a couple patterns out on Ravelry right now that are pretty recently released that I really want to cast on, but I don't have, I don't know, I can't figure out suitable yarn for yet that I already have. And I kind of don't want to buy more yarn. But the Sonder shawl, which is by Helen Stewart, it's the last of her Shawl Society shawls. And I ended up buying the whole collection once that shawl came out because I loved it so much. It's knit in a bulky weight yarn, which I don't have any of. And it's knit side to side, and the cast on edge is like a certain amount of stitches, it's wide, and then you decrease along the whole thing until you get to a small number of stitches, and then you cast that off. And there's like tassels here and here, and I think here. And so it's pretty much just a really long, elongated triangle, and I really like it. I really want to make it. I've got a good amount of worsted that I might try to make it with, but we'll see. I also thought about just spinning some yarn to make it, but we'll see. I also really like the Stay Soft shawl that was put out by Vera Valimaki recently. It's really cool. It's an elongated triangle shawl, where it's flat on the top, and then it's like a triangle shawl, but just really long. And I think it'll be so long that it'll be a good triangle shawl for me. And it's with three colors, and it's kind of got one color down one edge, and then the two colors. I'll put a picture of it somewhere. It's really cool. So it's a three color shawl. I have an idea. I'm really bad at three color shawls. No, I have made one. But the one that I made, two of the colors are almost exactly the same. I'm not that great with color combinations, so I never can put three yarns I already have together for a three color shawl. So I'm looking through my stash. I have two colors that I think would go good together. I would just need to find a third color. But I've been thinking about that shawl a lot lately. I really want to make it. The other things I've been kind of fantasizing about are yarns that I already have that I really want to make into something, but I can't figure out good patterns for yet. I'm working towards it though. Let me grab them my way over here. So I've got this really beautiful yarn. Most of it's Madeline Tosh. This one is from her. Forget what collection it is. It's like her natural wool collection or something like that. And this one is Mountain Merino wool. It's a sport weight. in the rose-colored glasses colorway. And it's just, it's a natural with these black and pink speckles in it. And I don't have much. It's 200 yards of a sport weight. So I've either wanted to do a hat or some fingerless mitts or some mittens with it. But I am not sure yet. I've been kind of cruising Ravelry trying to figure out which one I want to do. I'm thinking mittens, but I'm not sure yet. We'll see. Hopefully I cast this on soon. I've been thinking about this yarn a lot. It's really beautiful wool. It's really beautifully spun, and it's really nice and subtle with the colors. And my next ones are, it's kind of a crazy color combination. Well, it's not really. It's a lot of speckles is what it is, and I don't know what I would do with it, but I've been staring at these three skeins together. So what this is two Madeline Tosh skeins. This one is her solo speckles collection, where it's just natural with teal speckles. And this is the BFL light base. It's a single BFL fingering weight. And then the next one is same base from Madeline Tosh in the Peppermint Patty colorway. And this is a speckled colorway where with that same teal and pink. So got those two so far. And then the third one is Hedgehog Fibers in Exploding Peacock, which has, there we go, speckles of blue, teal, pink, and yellow and orange. So I thought these would be really cool all in one kind of, would it be like a speckle gradient? I don't know. I just thought they would be really cool together. I don't know what to do with it though. I feel like a lot of the three color shawls rely on like one kind of speckled colorway and the rest kind of tonals. And I feel like this would be kind of crazy, kind of too crazy, unless it was just like a gradient, like the least speckled one at the top, then switching into the pink and blue, then into the most speckled, which is the hedgehog. So I don't know what pattern to do yet, but I really want to put these three yarns together. Yeah, I think that would be cool. So that is it. I wonder what you guys have been fantasizing about knitting. Tell me about some patterns you've been dying to cast on, or some of your own stash yarn that you've been dying to cast on but can't figure out what to make out of it yet. So head on over to the Ravelry group, and in the show notes or in the thread for this episode, let me know. Let me know what you've been thinking about in terms of patterns and yarn and stuff like that. Yeah, that is all I have for you this week. I hope you had fun watching. I had fun showing you what I'm doing. I hope you join me next week. If you liked the episode, go ahead and like it and subscribe if you want to be kept up to date with future episodes. This is Dynamite Trujillo signing off. Until next time, have a really nice week. Bye.